Hawaii is not under a tsunami watch or advisory now. The ocean conditions are being monitored by the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center. Our Marissa Yumane is in Eva with the latest.
Hey, Joe, that's right. We're here right at the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center, and what a sigh of relief when we found out that Hawaii and all the other South Pacific nations are in the clear. Now, with me now is director of the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center, Chip McCreary. Thank you so much for joining us. If you could talk a little bit about what kind of wave action some of the South Pacific islands may have seen, even if it was small.
Well, we know there was a tsunami generated by this earthquake. Magnitude 8 is quite a large earthquake. Thankfully, as you mentioned, we're in the clear here in Hawaii. We're not expecting much of anything here. But in the South Pacific Islands near the epicenter, there was a larger tsunami. The largest signal we actually measured was only about a meter or roughly 3 feet above the normal tide level, and that was right there in Santa Cruz, the Santa Cruz Islands, where the earthquake was located. But we can't monitor an entire coastline. We can only monitor places where we have gauges. So it could have been larger along some of their coasts. We've also measured waves in the Solomon Islands and I believe in Fiji as well, but nothing larger than that 1 meter reading. So it looks like this was not it was not certainly not a huge tsunami. There still could have been damage in some of those places near the epicenter.
I know, considering it was an 8.0 magnitude earthquake, that's huge. Are you surprised that there really wasn't that much of a big, large tsunami generated?
Not really so much. An 8.0 is really kind of, although it's a huge earthquake, it's at the bottom end of the scale for generating a really large tsunami, other than maybe a large, very localized tsunami, which will still, the evidence is still out on that. We don't know exactly what happened in the Santa Cruz Islands.
And can you tell me a little bit about what's going on inside that building right now, what you folks are looking for?
Well, we have canceled the warning for the South Pacific. It doesn't mean that they're not still seeing some wave action down there, but essentially the places that we're going to get hit with anything that could have been a destructive tsunami would have already been impacted, and maybe the waves are dying down in those places. And it's really up to the local authorities who can monitor those coasts firsthand to make some decisions if they've evacuated people, when it might be safe to return. And our people here will just continue to monitor the sea level gauges around the Pacific. Even though it's a small tsunami, we will probably see this on gauges all around the Pacific, but our gauges can measure things that are only even just an inch tall. So,
all right. Thank you so much, Chip McCreary, here at the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center. And again, no threat of a tsunami for Hawaii or any of the South Pacific Islands. Reporting live from Eva, Marissa Yamane, KHON2 News.